In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Photoshop to create a multi-post seamless panorama on Instagram. Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Photoshop template that will allow you to make seamless panoramas in Instagram. You probably have seen those posts before. There are those posts on Instagram that show you a seamless panel. In reality, those are multiple images that were sliced up by Photoshop or another app. Of course, in this video, we're going to use Photoshop to slice those images up. But not just that, I'm also going to show you how to make a template. That way, this process becomes really easy. And I'm also going to provide you with the template that I create that you can just download and start using right away. Just like every other tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com, you're going to learn a whole bunch of new techniques and tricks, including how to work with the slice tool, the content aware scale, and many more tips and tricks. And stick around until the end of the tutorial where I'll show you how to use the template that I'm providing. Okay, let's get started. So this is the panel that we're going to work with, but before we even start cutting it up, we need to create the template that we're going to use for this tutorial. So I'm going to go into File, in New, and this is a new document window in Photoshop CC. If you're in an older version, it may look a little different, but that's okay. Make sure that you enter a width of 1080 pixels and a height of 1080 pixels. And the reason we're using 1080 by 1080 is because that's what Instagram recommends. And a color profile of sRGB, which is the color profile that Instagram will use when it displays it online. Click on Create, and this creates a white box. And this is going to be the basis for our template. As you know, Instagram uses square images. You could also use portrait if you like. I'm going to focus on the square version of photos on Instagram in this tutorial. However, the template that I'm going to provide to you at the end of the tutorial will have the capability of using portrait images as well. So this is what we're working with. Now we have to think about how many images we want to use to slice up this image. And I want to use 4. So I'm going to go into Image, Canvas Size, then click on this center arrow pointing to the left, which will create a space on the right side. That means that whatever width we enter on here will expand the canvas to the right. Now we have to think about how wide we want this to be. We don't have to do any math because we can change pixels to percent and then just type in the percentage that we want. We want 400% because we want it to be 4 times as large so that we could have 4 different images. Press OK, and I'm going to double click on the hand tool to fit everything to screen. And there it is. Then I'm going to go into View, New Guide Layout, and under Columns, just type 4. Make sure that nothing else is selected except for maybe Clear Existing Guides, which will remove any guides that you have on your canvas. And press OK. So now we have these guides that tell us where each individual image will be. Now, if you're in an older version of Photoshop, you will not have access to the new guide layout option. Instead, I would recommend right-clicking on the rulers. If you don't see the rulers, you can press Control R, Command R on the Mac to enable and disable the rulers. Then right-click and select percent. And just add a guide under 25%. 50% and 75%, and that will divide your canvas onto 4 boxes. So you can do either method. And now we're going to use a tool that you probably haven't used before. This tool is used heavily in web design, and that is the slice tool, which is nested under the crop tool. So right here, this tool, the slice tool, allows you to create slices. So I can click and drag and create a slice out of that first box. Slices allow you to save multiple documents out of one image, so we can cut up the image into multiple pieces, and each of those pieces will become a new document. So we just cut up this slice here. Notice that we have 1 as a label and 2 as a label here. The user-generated slices are in blue, and the Photoshop-generated slices are in gray. So we can click and drag to create another slice here for the second image. Notice now that we have a number 2 here and it's in blue, and number 3 is this big rectangle and it's in gray. So we can just keep making slices. So we have 4 different slices, and I can also click on the slice select tool, and I can double click on any slice to bring up the slice options, and I can name my slice. So I can call it Instagram Seamless Panel 01. And I can also copy that. So I'm going to highlight it, press Control C, Command C on the Mac to copy, and press OK. Then I can double click on the second slice to bring up the slice options and just press Control V, Command V to paste and change the number to number 2. And the reason that we're naming slices is because the name that we give the slice will be the name of the file when it's exported. So I'm going to quickly rename the remaining two slices. And there we go. So now our template is pretty much complete. All we need to do is drag the image in and make it fit on those four boxes. So I'm gonna go into the original image that I was working with. I'm gonna click on the Move tool to select it. Then I'm gonna click and drag, hover over the tab that I'm working with, and then just release. If you hold Shift while you release, it'll place the image right in the center. Now, I'm gonna zoom out, and if I press Control T, Command T to transform, you'll see the bounding box. That's how large the image is. If I want to fit both the Opera House and the bridge onto that space, I won't be able to because the image is way too wide and I'm obviously squishing all those pixels. However, Photoshop offers a tool that we can use to fix this problem. So I'm going to press the Escape key to cancel that transformation. So what I'm going to do is press Control T, Command T to transform once again. I'm going to hold Alt, Shift, Option Shift on the Mac, click on the corner handles to scale that in and try to get as much of the detail as I can. Once I have enough, I could also use this amazing tool. If I go under Edit, I can select Content Aware and I can scale with Content Aware. So notice how I'm scaling the image, but I'm not really distorting it because now Photoshop is aware of the content of the image and it's only collapsing the pixels that don't have a lot of detail. So a lot of the sky and the water and mountains in this area are going to collapse. So that way we can fit both the Opera House and the bridge. Then I can hit Enter when I'm done. Then I can press V on the keyboard and reposition the image if I need to, but I don't think I do in this case. And by the way, if you want to find out more about how Content Aware works, not only with the Content Aware scale, but with all the tools that use Content Aware, then look down below in the description. I posted a link to a playlist that I created that covers all the tools with Content Aware. So check that out. And now we're ready to save. All I need to do is go into File, Export, Save for Web. If you're using an older version of Photoshop, Save for Web won't be under Export. It will actually be here where the Export menu is, Save for Web. But in Photoshop CC, you have to go into the Export menu and click on Save for Web. This is going to bring up this window, and all you need to do is make sure that you have JPEG selected, and you can select a quality. I'm going to go for the maximum quality, and then click on Save. Then from the Save Optimize As, make sure that under Slices, you have all slices selected. You could also select User Slices. Those are the slices that you generate and not the ones that Photoshop generates. Or you can select slices from the previous screen and only save those out. I'm going to select all slices and then click on Save. If I bring up the folder where those slices were saved, you can see that we're going to have an Images folder. And if I double click on that, you will see the four images that are going to be used to save into Instagram. At this point, all that you need to do is take these photos and upload them onto your phone so that you can post them onto Instagram. I like using Dropbox to get my photos onto my phone, but you can use Google Photos or you can even connect your phone straight into your computer and drag those in there. It doesn't really matter how you get them in there as long as they're in your phone. Once the photos are in your phone, you can open Instagram and click on the plus icon to create a new post. Then click on the multi-post icon and select the four photos from your phone. Tap Next, and you'll be able to preview the panel. It's not seamless here, but that's okay. Click on Next, then create your post, and click on the Share button. Once the post is loaded onto Instagram, you will be able to see the seamless post. You can scroll to the left, and you'll see that there is no seam in the post. What I want to talk to you about now is the free template that I'm including for you guys. It's basically the same as what you just saw me make, but it has a few extra features. Number one is it has up to 10 images. At the moment, Instagram allows you to upload up to 10 images in one post. So this template is optimized for that. And also, each box is longer vertically so that you can upload portrait photos if you like to create your panel. And the way that you would use this template is by simply selecting the crop tool and clicking and dragging to each corresponding guide depending on the number of images you want to use. So if you only want to use 4 photos like we did in the previous example, then crop over to the 4th slice like you see here, and then just click on the checkbox or hit enter or return on the Mac. And this will give you 4 slices that you can use for your photos. And this is a vertical photo. If you wanted to use the square photos, then click on the crop tool and drag up to this point and then hit enter, return on the Mac. And notice that once you do, the slices are updated and they will only save this square. And we can verify it by selecting the slice select tool. And notice that when I click on each individual slide, they will also crop alongside the image. And by the way, I would like to point out that the file that I'm providing is a PSDT. That is a Photoshop template file. So when I double click on that file, notice that it opens up in a new tab, but this is an untitled tab. That means that I cannot edit this original version, so I can't override it. So if you make any changes and save the file, you'll be saving a separate instance of this file. It's also very important to note that if you are not on Photoshop CC, you will not be able to use this template file. So if you're in an older version of Photoshop, simply right-click on the file, select rename, and remove the T from the file type. Click on yes, and that turns it into a regular Photoshop file, a regular PSD. If I double-click on that file, it will open up in a new tab. However, notice that the tab now reads Instagram panel template.psd. So if you save this PSD, you will override the template. And if you want to find out more about how Photoshop templates work, then check out my tutorial titled 3 Photoshop Hacks That You Probably Don't Know. The first hack that I talk about is Photoshop templates, and I'll post the link to that video down below in the description. And by the way, don't forget to check me out on Instagram at jrfromptc. You can find the post that I used for this tutorial, the Sydney Panorama, and leave a comment down below in the description. You can even tag me at JRFromPTC if you decide to create your own seamless posts. That way I can check it out. Or you can use the hashtag PTCVids. And of course, don't forget to subscribe here on YouTube. Click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you at the next tutorial.